to this find out our fucking names.
Spyware. It can remotely access text messages, emails, and calls.
Spyware. The spyware technology.
This is everywhere.
Specialized phone spying software.
This is an industry that should not exist.
If only I had some waffles to go with this. You know, I get sick and tired of Craig watching my every move. It's like I can't get any privacy. Every time I go on the internet, I see ads that are weirdly specific and, well, kind of invasive. If you're with me on this one, I can tell you what the major source of all of this data gathering is. Your smartphone. Specifically, apps that are actually spyware on these phones. Whether you love Android, iPhone, or the ever-popular HTC Cha-Cha, data gathering practices have gotten worse. In fact, a 2018 study of nearly 1 million free Android apps revealed that most of them send information to third-party sources. Much of this information has nothing to do with data to improve the app. Instead, major companies like Verizon, Microsoft, and Alphabet, Google's parent company, use this information to better target you with advertising. Even worse, criminals can use these tracking tools to steal personal information. This information includes things like credit card numbers, your address, your passwords that you enter. So, knowing that a vast majority of phone apps aren't good for you, what do? Below, I'll provide you with what you need to stay safe. This video will go through four things. How to know if an app is spying on you, what data these major companies gather from you, a list of the most notorious apps that steal your data, and steps you can take today to keep your data safe. First, let's ask an important question. How do you know your apps are spying on you? Well, it all starts by going to your phone's permission list. To do this on Android, go to Settings, Apps and Notifications, and Advanced Permissions Manager. From this page, you'll see a breakdown of different permissions. Browse through those permissions and ask yourself whether it makes sense for these apps to have permissions here. If not, tap on the inappropriate app and tap the deny button. Through iOS, go to Settings, Privacy, and browse through the various permissions. Take the same discerning approach to deny any app that doesn't need permissions where they have them. Alternatively, there are other situations that tell you whether your phone has unwanted trackers. Some situations where your smartphone might be in danger include an unusual amount of data usage or battery drainage, unusual behavior while the phone is in standby or not in use, the phone shutdown process taking an unusually long amount of time, your phone getting hot, autocorrect acting up and not just with profanity, and finally, unfamiliar applications on your device. If your phone is jailbroken or disconnected from the original mobile provider, you are more likely to run into these situations. Despite mobile providers being part of the data tracking problem, they often provide security for your phone. This brings us to an important question. What data do companies collect? Companies collect these types of data from you. Personal information, like your name or social security number. Behavioral data, that includes purchase histories, product use information, and transactional data. Engagement data, which tracks how you use a company's website or app. And finally, data on the buyer's responses, which include customer reviews and willingness to purchase a product. Companies collect your data through submission forms, behind-the-scenes tools, like third-party cookies, and app-based permission requests. Companies mainly use this information to hit you with personalized advertising. For example, Google uses location data to hit you with local restaurant ads. Now, there are laws in place that limit this tracking, like the UK's privacy and electronic communications regulations. But companies still don't make it easy to deny tracking. Of course, nothing is stopping you from entering false information. Now you know what to look for, but what apps are the most notorious for stealing your information? Well, let's look at this together. Right, Craig? That's the spirit. So now we will list out five apps that are known for stealing your information. First on the list is the new kid in the social media block, TikTok. TikTok is relatively new, but it has made waves regarding data collection. In 2019, the company was fined $5.7 million by the FCC, a US communications regulator, in violation of the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act. TikTok uses information from the videos you like and watch. It combines this user data to target you with more suitable advertising. TikTok is a massive user of third-party data, collecting information even from your clipboard. The app's creators are incredibly unspecific on how they use the data, so most people don't even know where it goes. The second app we'll be looking at advertises itself as a tool for encrypted communications, WhatsApp. despite claims that WhatsApp uses powerful encryption. A ProPublica report showed that Facebook paid over 1,000 contract workers to read through these seemingly private messages. Meta, the company behind Facebook, can do this because they own WhatsApp. The European Union took this issue to court, addressing a supposed lack of transparency in the WhatsApp app. This result was a 225 million euro penalty for failing to be transparent about how they use data. The third app we're going to look at is OkCupid, an app that helps people find love. Now, the prospect of finding love sounds exciting, doesn't it? Although, depending on the dating profile, love might be a bit out of the question. OkCupid had a vulnerability where it was easy for hackers to place false link schemes and landing pages. So you would go to a page that looked like OkCupid, enter some login data, and provide it willingly to hackers. As far back as 2016, the user data of 70,000 members was released by people who weren't hackers. Instead, they were university students accessing publicly available information. OkCupid called this a terms of service violation, but all you have to do to get this information is create an account. Yet another OkCupid exploit resulted in leaked information of a user's location data. Using this information, stalkers could feasibly triangulate where you live based on your last known location. Cam Scammer is an extreme example because it was found by a user to have malware included. Despite this, it was allowed on the Google Play Store for a period, stealing user information during its wait. It was eventually removed and re-uploaded with better results. Still, just know that even when you get official content from the Google Play Store, it might have a virus. We'll discuss some antiviruses that you can check out later. The last app that we're going to look at is probably one you all know, Angry Birds. Angry Birds is a topic that's been talked about by Edward Snowden, a known
former US intelligence contractor and whistleblower.
He drew attention to how the National Security Agency took from this data resource with no reason. With nearly 2 billion downloads under its belt, Angry Birds is a prime target to steal a lot of information from you. A current lawsuit is underway about Angry Birds, potentially violating the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act. After all, Angry Birds doesn't discriminate about the data that it collects. It just collects information without thinking. Many games also use the same strategy. So now that you know different apps to avoid, how do you protect yourself while trying to make use of these smartphone marketplaces? First, you need to make sure that your shields are up. To do this, you need two tools at your disposal: antivirus software and a virtual private network app. The antivirus software ensures that Trojan downloaders or other viruses do not cause damage and are often stopped before they can do anything. Many antiviruses, such as Norton or Bitdefender, catch apps based on how they behave, allowing them to stop even new app-based viruses. Virtual private networks, or VPNs, securely encrypt your connection and traffic logs, making it impossible for these apps to get any useful information from you. In this way, third-party tracking cookies become worthless. Two great examples of VPN apps that you can download include Surfshark and NordVPN. Surfshark is inexpensive and incredibly secure. It uses AES 256 encryption to keep your data private and impossible to crack. If you can afford to spend a bit more, NordVPN offers the same security, but it's faster. If you want discounts on the best VPNs or antivirus softwares, check out the description in this video. You will find links that will save you a whole ton of money, so you can focus on staying secure. Beyond that, you can stay secure online with the following tips. Double check all of the app permissions and only allow those that make sense. Stick to proven companies with clear privacy policies that explain what they do with your data. Avoid apps that have too much programmatic advertising. Don't download too many apps and overwhelm yourself with where your data goes. If possible, stick to registering for these apps using false information or data that cannot come with you. Don't jailbreak your phones. Avoid downloading apps away from the Google Play or Apple App Stores. Following these tips and setting up your defense will keep you protected. Hey guys, thanks for watching the video. We super appreciate you stopping by and would love your feedback in the comments section. Also, like the video to help us spread the word and subscribe if you want to see more. With your support, our channel continues to thrive and we can't thank you enough for it. See you later.